Here are three cracking ideas you can use in your marketing videos to make them stand out from the crowd, make them more engaging, and therefore, hopefully, increase the amount of conversions you get from them. Hi there, my name is Peter Thomson. I'm delighted to welcome you to this video. As the UK's most prolific information product creator, I've been making videos for the last 15 years. I have made some awful videos. I've made some pretty good videos, and occasionally I've made one or two really stunning videos. And there are three specific things that I look at in my videos that really does help me set them apart from the crowd. And they're very simple things to do. And I want to share those with you today. So the first one is this. It's so simple, really, and yet so many people don't bother to do it. They particularly don't bother to do it when they do things like Zoom calls or Skype calls or things like that. And the first thing is to use a video background in the sense of a green screen. Now, I've got a couple of green screens behind me at the moment. They're what's called pull-up or collapsible green screens, and I've actually got them overlapped. And you would think with that overlap, let me show you without a background on it. You see that great big, whereabouts? No, it's this side, isn't it? You see this great big line here where the overlap is. In fact, if I actually turn around and put my arm behind it, look, my arm even disappears. So you can see there's a massive big overlap there. But of course, having the green screen there means that for all the videos that I do, I can use idea number two, which is to put in an appropriate background. Now, I love putting different backgrounds in for different ideas. So for example, if I was talking about running a particular workshop, I would do something with a workshop background. If I was saying, welcome to the workshop of lead generation, I might put a different background for that. If I was talking about a product that I'd bought in a supermarket area, I would put in a background for that. And I would find these backgrounds online where I was able to use them, so I wasn't going against anybody's license in that way. So I'm making sure they are licensed to be used. And obviously you can use sites like Pixabay, where you can occasionally buy coffee for the artists, or you can use Unsplash or all sorts of other places that you can search online for royalty-free images. So I would urge you to put images in. However, and in, by the way, in just a moment, I'm going to share with you a little technique that so few people know, and yet it is just an absolute cracker when it comes to improving the power of your video for a very specific reason. Anyway, I would suggest that you put in different backgrounds for different ideas. However, put in occasionally a video background. Now, what I do is this. If I've got a particular theme that I'm doing, let's say, for example, I'm talking about fishing in the right pond, albeit I'm talking about lead generation, then I will find a video, a bit like this one behind me now, which is a video of fish swimming around in an aquarium, but it'll do for the analogy, the metaphor of fish swimming around a pond, and we've got to use the right bait and the right hook and all the rest of it. And if you've seen some of my other videos, you may even have seen me use this background before. So I'll start off the video, and the background behind me, rather than a static image, will be a video image. And then I will move to a static image, which is a screen grab of the, listen carefully, end frame of the video that I'll use for the rest of the body of the video itself. So let me play it for you, you can see what's happening. At the moment, you're seeing it's the video going along. And as the video comes to its end screen, which I've made end now, I've then taken a screen grab. I use a Mac, so I've used, Command up and Command Shift and 4. So I've taken a grab, not of the whole of my screen, but just of the part of the screen that I want. So I've selected the whole of the end slide, and then I've inserted the end slide for the background for the rest of the video. When it gets right to the end of the video, let's imagine that's now, I then bring the video version behind me. So it starts off with a video behind me, then it goes into a still behind me, then it goes into a video behind me. However, here comes the exciting bit that most people don't use. Let me change the background, the still background behind me. I'll put a different background in now. You gather I'm doing this live, and then I'm doing the now bit afterwards when I fiddle about in iMovie, because it's iMovie I use for the editing. So I've put in a background, and now I'm going to change that background, and you watch what happens. You see, it's the same background, however, I've blurred the background. Why would I bother blurring the background? Well, quite simply, because if the background is blurred, then by contrast and the way that the human eye works, I become more in focus. And because it's me and my message that I want you to focus on, then firstly, I'm making sure that I'm looking straight through the camera lens to you. And secondly, that I am more in focus than anything else. So that's a really important point. Now, it's quite simple, actually, to blur a static image. And some people think it's difficult to blur a movie, but I'll show you how to do both now. So to blur a static image, it's very easy to get a piece of software. The one that I use, let me just look on my computer. It's called, let me have a look here, get the correct name. It's called Photo Blur FX. So you can download Photo Blur FX, and all you do then is you load a photo into it. Here's a screen grab of that. You change the amount of blur, what's called Gaussian blur, how much blur you want on it to make it either more or less blurred. And then you save that as a picture and you bring that in and replace your green screen with the blurred picture. What about with a video? Can you blur the video? Yes, you can. Quite simple, actually. All you do is this, is you import the video into iMovie. And then you select the blurred title. So you get that title and you overlay the title across the whole of the video track. So it's from right from the start to the end. Then you remove the words title because you don't want a title in there. You're just using the blurring effect. You're doing this solely on the video you're going to use for the background. So you take your background video, you import it into iMovie, you put a title on it, the blur title, you take the actual words title off, and then you export that as a film, as a file, so it's saved as a file. It's my, obviously something I've got to remember to do. So you export that as a file, and then you bring it back into iMovie to use as the background of your video. Let me show you it all in play. I'll do a little screen recording where you can see me do it. So here it's coming up now. So as you can see, what I've done, I've brought in a little bit of film. I've grabbed the title, the blur title. I've stuck it on top. I've extended it. I've removed the word title. And now I'm exporting that as a file and I'll call it blurred background number one. And there it is. Next time I bring it back into iMovie, here I go again. And then I add my green screen effect by sticking my normal video on top of the video blur I've just created. Isn't that fantastic? So you see what we've done here is we've got three cracking ideas, haven't we? Firstly, use green screen. Secondly, use appropriate backgrounds to the content that you're using. And thirdly, the little known bit about blurring either your static bits behind you, the images that you're using. Remember, if you're taking a screen grab, always take it from the end of the movie, not the beginning, because it'll be a slight different picture of that. And you can even blur the video by sticking it into my movie and doing exactly what I've just said. All of these ideas will make your videos different, make them stand out from the crowd. And if they stand out from the crowd, they're likely to be more engaging, as long as the content's any good and you know what you're talking about, which I'm sure you will be, and hopefully I was today. If you've got any comments on this, then please put it down there because I'm happy to engage in a dialogue with you. And by all means, send me videos that I can have a look at to see how you've used these ideas. By doing this, you will build for yourself a business and a life of choice where you have freedom from everything that may have held you back and freedom to be, do and have whatever you set your heart and mind upon. I always enjoy putting these together for you, especially when there's extra bits and pieces I've got to fiddle with, which I've had to do today. I'm looking forward to the next one, which is again going to be about marketing videos and another little technique that you can use. Here we go. Bye. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos. Then click to watch the next video. Remember to visit our website at peterthomson.com and download your free copy of my latest book, How to Write Your Business Book in 5 Days or Less. Until next time, every success.